Stinger transition is an animation that smoothly switches between two different scenes. I made the transition with 50 to 60 frames. I think it's better to have at least one frame that covers the entire scene, with full transparency at the start and the end of the animation. I use UV with transparent background, standard color, then render it as PNG format with RGBA color for the alpha channel. For the compositing, you can add lens distortion and RGB curves, then duplicate that lens distortion for the alpha. You can make your transition with your logo as the main object by turn your logo into 3D in Blender. You can just import the SVG file, give it thickness and smooth the edge, then add material. I just use basic metallic material. If you want to make simple 2D transition, you can just use plane as the background. Add location or kill keyframe to it. You can also make simple 3D transition by rotating your logo. Add holdout material behind your logo. Then add 360 rotation keyframe to your logo. And location keyframe to your camera. Edit the timing in Graph Editor. You can combine the simple logo transition with gate animation for the background. Make the simple gate. You can mirror the other side. I used 3 material for it. This image for the base color. Then brick texture for the roughness. This image from Unsplash. And basic metallic material. Add location keyframe for the closing animation. Parent it with empty object, then add noise modifier to that empty X and Z location for camera shake effect. Or maybe you only want the gate transition animation. Make this corridor. For the material, I just use the same material for the gate. Then add our gate. Adjust the keyframe by make the gate close then open again. Repositioning the camera shake effect. Don't forget to parent the corridor to the empty object that has camera shake effect. Add Y location keyframe for the camera. I render this animation on cycle. From this animation, we get the concept of corridor transition. We can make the transition just move forward, not move backward, then forward. So I make this wormhole transition. Basically, this animation is a combination between loop tunnel animation with gel node from Clever Body. Make the tunnel animation with curve, then add camera and light. Add follow path to it, with some gap between the camera and the light values. Duplicate the curve, add round bevel to it. Convert it to mesh. Then add gel node to it. Basically, it's a displacement with transparent material. Then add wireframe modifier to the tunnel. You can download this project file for free on my Patreon page. That's all for today's video.